photo. She must be the meanest old woman that ever was. Let's go find Uncle Henry and Auntie Em. They'll take care of her. Auntie Em? Auntie Em?
56,
oh, Auntie Em!
57, 58.
Oh, just listen to what Miss Gulch did to Toto. Oh, she, Dorothy, please, we're trying to count. Oh, but Aunt Em, she hit
him. Don't bother us now, honey. You see, this old incubator's gone bad. We're likely to lose a lot of our chicks.
Oh, the poor little things. Oh, but Aunt Em, Miss Gulch hit Toto right over the back with the rake. Just because she says he gets into her garden and chases her nasty old cat every day.
60s. Dorothy, we're busy.
But he doesn't do it every day. Just once or twice a week. And Toto can't catch her old cat anyway. And now she says she's going to.
Dorothy, please.
Oh, Uncle Henry, can you do something?
I'm doing something right now, honey. So just stay out of our hair.
Oh, all right.
Who was the genius suggested we move the wagon before the wheel was on?
It ain't so heavy with one less. That makes sense, don't it?
Sense or no sense, when I lift up the axle, you two shove her on.
Zeke, Hickory, know what Miss Gulch did to Toto? She...
I swear they made this new wheel smaller than the other three.
She tried to kill him!
Big or smaller, get it on here. Before my arms are buckling out of their sockets. Ain't a statue, you know. Ain't made iron.
All right, all right.
Why won't anyone listen? Don't you care about Toto?
Ow! You got my finger!
Hunk, what am I gonna do about Miss Gulch? Just because Toto chases her old cat.
Now look at Dorothy, you ain't using your head about Miss Gulch. Well, ain't you got no brains?
Sure I have brains.
Well, why don't you use them? When you come home, don't go by Miss Gulch's place. Well, then Toto won't get in the garden, when you won't get in no trouble, see?
Quit just standing there and clear that junk out of the way. We got a parcel of lumber to haul from town before the weather turns.
Will do, Mr. Gale.
Farmhand. Zeke, what am I going to do?
For a start, kid, don't let that old gulch have her giant buffalo yet. She ain't nothing to be afraid of. You just gotta stand up to her, that's all, with a little courage, a little grit.
I'm not afraid of her.
That's what I wanted to hear. Now walk with your head up, your chest out, and the next time she squawks, just draw right up to her and spit in her eye. That's what I'd do.
Would you really?
Sure I would. In this life, you gotta walk tall, you gotta shoot straight, and then you got no reason to be afraid of nothing or nobody.
Zeke,
what are you trying to do, kill a guy?
How can you be so cruel?
Oh, it's just a rib, Dorothy.
Can't you see how white he is? You really scared him.
Who was scared?
You were scared. If he was a jackrabbit, you'd be in the next county by now.
What's all this jabber-whopping when there's work to be done? I know three shiftless farmhands that'll be out of a job before they know it.
Wow, we was just having a little fun, Mrs. Gale.
Farm's no place for fun. You want fun, go join a circus.
I might just do that. Be a strong man, see the world.
Don't start posing for it now. Here, can't work on an empty stomach, have some cookies.
Gosh, Mrs. Gale.
Just baked.
Thanks, well.
You don't gotta sit down and eat them. Get that wagon hitched up, and Zeke, you go feed them hogs before they worry themselves into anemia.
Yes.
Oh, but Aunt Em, really? Do you know what Miss Gulch said she was going to do to Toto? Well, she said she was...
Dear, stop imagining things. You always get yourself into a fret over nothing.
Well,
now, you just help us out today and find yourself a place where you won't get in any trouble.
Some place where there isn't any trouble. I wonder if there is such a place, Toto. There must be... It's not a place you can get to by a boat or a train. It's far, far away. Behind the moon, beyond the rain. When all the world is a hopeless jumble and the raindrops tumble all around. Heaven opens a magic lane. Thank you.
Cookies if you've got the money to sit a while.
I'm afraid I have no appetite, Mrs. Gale. Indeed, I am so shaken by the ferocious attack of your niece's vicious dog that I may never eat again.
You don't eat, you'll waste away, and I'd hate to see you dwindle.
Dorothy, could you bring Toto out here a minute? I'm sure if Dorothy's done anything to upset you, she'll be only too glad to apologize as best she can.
It's gone beyond apologies, Mrs. Gale. I've laid an official complaint with the county sheriff.
Was he sober?
Dorothy, Miss Gulch here seems very upset.
That dog's a menace to this community.
That's not true.
As an act of public service, young woman, I am taking that dog to the sheriff and make sure he's destroyed.
Destroyed? Toto? Oh, you can't. You mustn't. Oh, Uncle Henry, Auntie Emma, you won't let her, will you?
Of course we won't. Well, we have?
Oh, please, Aunt Em. Toto didn't mean to. He didn't know he was doing anything wrong. I'm the one who ought to be punished. You can send me to bed without supper.
You hear how sorry the child is. Perhaps if she promises to give your place a wide berth.
If you don't hand that dog over right away, I'll bring a damage suit that'll take your whole farm. There's a law protecting folks against dogs that bite.
How would it be if she keeps him tied up? He's real gentle. With gentle folks, that is.
That's for the sheriff to decide. Here's the order allowing me to take him. Unless you want to go against the law.
What's it say, Henry?
Just what she says. You gotta hand him over, Dorothy.
No, I won't let you take him.
Here's what I'll be taking him in, so he can't attack me again.
Oh, no, no, no. I won't let you take him. No, you go away. No, you wicked old witch. I'll bite you myself.
Dorothy!
No, please, Aunt Em and Uncle Henry, don't let him take Toto. Don't let him take him. Please! Oh, stop her!
It's no use running, Dorothy.
Hickory, I thought you were my friend.
He is your friend. We all are.
You can't fight the law, honey. Some things are bigger than all of us.
Let me have him, Dorothy.
Oh, please, please.
Put him in the basket, Henry.
That's more like it.
Oh, don't, Uncle Henry!
Come on, Tuck.
Oh, Toto!
Elmira Gulch, just because you own half the county doesn't mean you have the power to run the rest of us. For 23 years, I've been dying to tell you what I thought of you, and, well, being a Christian woman, I can't say it.
Well, I can. So if you don't want to hear it, you better peddle your carcass off of my land.
I don't take kindly to that kind of talk, Henry Gale. Just remember, I have friends in high places.
Well, why don't you climb on your broomstick and go visit us?
Come on, Mr. Gale.
You got the horses hitched to that wagon yet?
Nearly done, Mr. Gale.
Well, nearly ain't good enough. You get it done right now. Sky's getting darker every minute. Gosh darn it.
Come inside.
I'm not going anywhere with you. If you really loved me, you wouldn't have let Toto go.
She had an order from the sheriff, Dorothy. What did you expect us to do? Wave a wand and make it disappear?
Still, you could have tried at least. You stood there like you were stuffed or something.
I just couldn't think of anything. I'm sorry.
One mean old woman and you were scared of her?
It weren't my place to interfere.
And you were worst of all. You stopped Toto getting away. I just to hate you.
Oh, don't say that, Dorothy. You make me feel terrible inside. My heart was all tore out.
I don't care. And I never want to see any of you ever again. Never, ever, ever.
Toto was the only friend I had in the world. Now I got no one to talk to, no one to play with, and I'll never see him again for as long as I live.
Toto? Oh, Toto! Oh, you got away from that horrible woman. Oh, you wonderful dog. Oh, but she'll be coming back for you any minute. Oh, we've got to get away. We've got to run away. Oh, we'll need food for me and a bone for you. And then we've got to get far, far away from here. And we're never coming back.
Get off my land, Miss Gulch.
I did, but the dog got away.
He can't even enjoy your company much.
Where the little girl is, that's where I'll find the dog. Kindly bring her out here.
You never give up, do you? Dorothy!
She ain't in the house, Henry. That fresh batch of cookies is missing. My picture from the mantle, that's gone too.
Sounds like you've a runaway on your hands. If she's on the road, I'll find her. And then I'll take that dog back for good.
You're so anxious to have it, you should have looked after it then.
Don't blame me. The catch of my basket's faulty. That's the last time I buy anything from a charity bazaar.
Traveling in disguise. No, you're going on a visit?
Actually,
you're running away.
How did you guess?
Professor Marvel never guesses. He knows. Now, why are you running away?
Oh, why?
No, don't tell me. Hey, my dear, they don't understand you at home. They don't appreciate you. You want to see other lands, big cities, big mountains, and big oceans. Aha!
Why, it's just like you could read what was inside of me.
It's my trade, my calling. See what it says on the side of my conveyance.
Toto, that's not polite.
He's perfectly welcome, as one dog to another, eh? Now let's see, where were we?
Oh, Professor, why can't we go with you and see all the crowned heads of Europe?
Ooh, do you know any?
Yes, well, you must mean the thing. Well, I never do anything without consulting my crystal first. Here, sit right down here. Now watch, as I conjure, out of the air, out of thin air, this very genuine, magic, authentic crystal, used by the priests of the Isis and Osiris in the days of the pharaohs of Egypt, when Cleopatra first saw the approach of Julius Caesar, and Mark Anthony, and so on, and so on. Now, you'll hold out your hand to help me look into the future. You'd better close your eyes, my child, for a moment, to be better in tune with the infinite. We can't do these things without reaching out into the infinite first. Ah, yes. All right, you may open them now. We'll gaze into the crystal together. What's this I see? A house. With a picket fence.
Oh, that's our farm!
Yes, yes, there's a woman. She's wearing a polka dot dress. Her face is caramel.
Oh, that's Aunt Emily.
Ah, yes, her name is Emily.
That's right. What's she doing?
I can't quite see. Oh, why, she's crying.
Oh?
Someone has hurt her. Someone has just about broken her heart.
Why would anyone do that?
I don't know, but it's someone she loves very much. Someone she's been very kind to. Someone she's taken care of in sickness.
I had the measles once, and she stayed by me every minute.
Uh-huh.
No, but that was when I was very small. She doesn't care about me at all now, and I don't care about her.
Well, that's not what the crystal says.
They were going to kill Toto, and she did nothing to stop them.
I don't see any of that in the crystal. All I see is a woman who misses you very much and loves you.
What's she doing now?
I can't quite see. Oh, why, she's putting her hand on her heart. She's dropping down onto the bed.
Oh, you don't suppose she could really be sick, do you? Oh, I've got to get home right away.
But what's this? I thought you were coming along with me.
Oh, no, I've got to get to her right away. Oh, come on, Julio, come on. Goodbye, Professor Marvel, and thanks a lot.
Goodbye, safe journey. Better get undercover. There's a storm blowing. A whopper. Whew. Poor kid. I hope she gets home all right.
Auntie Emma? Auntie Emma? No. from Kansas. Oh, well, is that the witch?
Toto? Toto's my dog.
Well, I'm a little mother. The Munchkins called me because a new witch had just struck a house on the Wicked Witch of the East. And there's the house. And here you are. And those legs are all that's left of the Wicked Witch of the East. Oh. And so, what the Munchkins want to know is, are you a good witch or a bad witch?
But I've already told you, I'm not a witch at all. Witches are old and ugly.
Oh, what was that? The Munchkins, they're laughing because I'm a witch. I'm Glinda, the Witch of the North.
Here you are?
Oh, well, I beg your pardon, but I've never heard of a beautiful witch before. Only bad witches are ugly. The Munchkins are happy because you freed them from the Wicked Witch of the East.
Oh, but if you please, what are Munchkins?
The little people who live in this land, and blue is their favorite color. This is Munchkin Land, my dear, and you are their national heroine. It's all right. You may come out now and thank her. It's all right. Come on now. It's all right. Come on out. Come out. Come out. Wherever you are.
Yeah.
the house.
Under the house?
It's my fault. I'm so sorry. My house dropped on her.
You dropped your house on my sister? How could anyone be so unbelievably clumsy?
Look closer. You recognized her then?
Of course I recognized her. Who else would wear ruby slippers with those socks? The ruby slippers. Little girl, you have done me a service. I shall don the ruby slippers, which will make my power greater than ever.
Yeah.
though.
Pardon me, that way's a very nice way.
Who said that? Oh, don't be silly, Toto. Scarecrows don't talk.
It's pleasant down that way, too.
That's funny. Wasn't he pointing the other way?
Of course, people do go both ways.
Why? You did say something, didn't you? Are you doing that on purpose, or can't you make up your mind?
Well, I haven't got a brain, only straw. So I ain't got a mind to make up.
Well, how can you talk if you haven't got a brain?
Well, I don't know. But some people without brains do an awful lot of talking, don't they?
Yes, I guess you're right. Can't you get down?
Down? No, you see, I've got a pole stuck up my back.
Oh, well, is there any way I could help you?
Of course, I'm not very bright about doing things, but if you'll just bend the nail down and back, maybe I'll just slip off.
I'll certainly try. Oh, it's an awful stiff nail.
Whoa. Oh, there goes some of me again.
Oh, does that hurt you?
Oh, no, I just keep picking it up and putting it back in again.
Oh, let me help you.
My, it's good to be free. Oh, did I scare you?
Oh, no, I just thought you hurt yourself.
But I didn't scare you.
No, of course not.
I didn't think so. You see, I gave you the scarecrow. They come from miles around just to eat my field.
Howdy, scarecrow.
And laugh in my face.
Sad scarecrow swinging on a pole. Until a blackbird singing on a fence.
Oh, the Lord gave me a soul, but forgot to give me common sense.
Said the blackbird, whoa, whoa, whoa. For the folk know what to do with common sense.
Said the scarecrow, could be pleasing just to reason out the reason of the witchness and the whiness and the whence. If I had an ounce of common sense,
why, shucks,
I could while away the hours, conferring with the flowers, consulting with the rain. And my head, I'd be scratching while my thoughts were busy hatching if I only had a brain. Oh, I'd unravel every riddle for any individual in trouble or in pain.
Oh.
If I only had a brain. Oh, I could tell you why the ocean's near the shore.
You could think of things you never thought before.
And then I'd sit and think some more. I would not be just a nothing. My head all full of stuffing, my heart all full of pain. I would dance and be merry, life would be a ding-a-derry if I only had a brain. Oh, I could tell you why the ocean's near the shore. I could think of things I never thought before.
And then he'd sit and think some more.
Gosh, it would be awful pleasing to reason out the reason for things I can't explain. Then perhaps I deserve ya and be even worthier of ya if I only had a brain.
Oh. Oh.
If I only had a brain. They would?
Oh, yes.
Well, where is Kansas?
That's where I live. And I want to get back there so badly. I'm going all the way to the Emerald City to ask the Wizard of Oz for help.
You're going to see the wizard?
Uh-huh.
Oh, do you think if I went with you, this wizard would give me some brains?
I couldn't say. But even if he didn't, you'd be no worse off than you are now.
Yes, that's true.
But maybe you'd better not. I've got a witch mad at me. You might get yourself into trouble.
Witch? Well, I'm not afraid of a witch. Well, I'm not afraid of anything. Oh, except a lighted match.
I don't blame you for that.
But I'd face a whole box full of them for the chance of getting a brain. Oh, look, I won't be any trouble because I don't eat a thing. And I won't try to manage things because I can't think. Well, won't you take me with you?
Of course I will.
Hooray! I'm going to get me a brain. Let's go.
Oh, you aren't starting out very well.
Oh, I'll try. Really, I will.
Two Oz.
Two Oz.
We want to see the wizard, the wonderful wizard of Oz. He is a visible wizard, never a wizard there was. If ever a lover a wizard there was, the wizard of Oz. And what
because
of the wonderful things he loves. We want to see the wizard, the wonderful wizard of Oz.
Too much of a stuffed shirt.
Just for that, you can eat as much of my hay as you like, and then you won't be hungry anymore.
Oh, no, Scarecrow. I couldn't do that.
Oh, you don't have to worry about me. So long as I keep my legs well stuffed, I can walk to Emerald City no matter what shape I'm in on top.
Oh, it's a very kind offer, but I don't eat hay.
Oh, well, perhaps it's just as well. A little Mother Field Mouse has a nest in here, and she wouldn't like to be disturbed.
Oh, look, Scarecrow, apples!
Apples? What's apples?
In the trees.
You mean all those little red birds hanging upside down by one leg?
They're not birds. They're something you eat, and they're delicious. Ouch! What do you think you're doing? Well, we've been walking a long ways, and I was hungry, and well... Did you say something?
Yeah. She was hungry.
She was hungry? How would you like it if someone come along and picked something off of you?
Oh, well, I'm sorry. I keep forgetting I'm not in Kansas.
Oh, come along, Dorothy. You don't want any of those apples. Yuck.
Are you hinting my apples aren't what they ought to be?
Don't know. It's just that, oh, she doesn't like little green worms.
Worms? Did he say worms?
That's what it sounded like to me.
He said worms.
I'll show you how to get apples. Sure, you got worms. Worms, caterpillars, and probably a whole bunch of... wood lice, too!
How dare you! Let's give it to them, girls!
Take that! And that! Baselander!
Look out, Dorothy!
How do you like them apples?
We like them just fine!
I've suddenly twigged!
So have I. They've made sacks of us all.
I think it's time we bow to them.
What?
Yes, oh, look!
Did you say something? Oh, he said oil can.
Oil can what?
Oil can? Oh, here it is. Oh, where would you like to be oiled first?
Well, he said his mouth. Oh, and the other side.
Yes, there.
Goodness, I can talk again. Oh, oil my arms, please. Oil my elbows.
Oh. What? Did that hurt?
No. No, it feels wonderful. I've held that axe up for ages.
Oh, my goodness. How did you ever get like this?
Oh, well, when I was flesh and blood like you, I fell in love with a munchkin maiden whose mother hated me. So, to stop me from marrying her daughter, she hired the Wicked Witch of the West to put an evil spell on my axe. And when I went to chop down a tree, it chopped off my leg instead.
It chopped your leg off?
That's terrible!
But By good fortune, I knew a wonderful tinsmith who got me a new leg, almost as good as the old one. And I went back to work, and do you know what happened?
Something terrible, I bet.
Well, I swung the axe again, and dang me if it didn't take off the other leg.
You should have got a new axe.
I suppose you're right. But I got me a new leg instead, and I went back to work.
Sure, we're persistent.
This time I chopped off both of my arms.
Why?
I can see how you could have chopped off one arm, but how did you manage to chop off the other one?
Well, I told you, the axe was enchanted.
Of course. See, Dorothy, if I had a brain, I could have worked that out for myself.
Sometimes I wish I hadn't gotten a new pair of arms. Because the last time I swung the axe was the worst time of all.
I don't want to hear this.
What happened?
Well, I split myself right down the middle.
Oh, you poor thing!
So, the tinsmith gave me a new head and body, but on the way home I got caught in a terrible rainstorm and I rusted solid.
Well, it just wasn't your day, was it?
I've been stuck here ever since.
Well, you're perfect now.
Oh, my neck. Oh, perfect. Well, just bang on my chest if you think I'm perfect. Go ahead, bang on it.
Beautiful! What an echo!
It's empty. Tinsmith forgot to give me a harp.
No harp. Oh.
All hollow. As long as I have no harp, I can never love my munchkin maiden.
Oh, please don't cry, Tin Man. You'll rest again.
I used to carve her name on every tree.
You can say that again!
Time ago.
Ran out of tin.
Well, then maybe you could come with us to the
Emerald City and ask the Wizard of Oz for a heart.
Well, I suppose the wizard wouldn't give me one when we got there.
Oh, but he will. He must. Oh, we've come such a long ways already.
You call that long? Why, you've only just begun.
You're the one who put the spell on my axe.
It certainly chopped you down to size, didn't it? And now you're helping the little lady along, are you, my fine gentleman? Well, stay away from her, for I'll stuff a match with you, Scarecrow. And you, Tin Man, I'll use you for a beehive.
Well, I'm not afraid of you.
Well, that just proves you don't have a brain. Here, allow me to educate you.
Oh, I'm on fire. Oh, fire, help.
Just remember, Scarecrow, helping that girl reach the Emerald City could be your last burning ambition.
Oh, I'm still not scared of her. I'll see a safety to the wizard now, whether I get a brain or not. Stuff a mattress with me, ha!
Well, I'll see you get to the wizard whether I get a heart or not. A beehive, bah! Let him try to make a beehive out of me.
Oh, you're the best friends anybody ever had. And it's funny, but I feel like I've known you all the time. But I couldn't have, could I?
I don't see how. You weren't around when I was stuffed and sewn together, were you?
And I've been standing over there rusting for the longest time.
I wish I could remember. But it really doesn't matter. We know each other now, don't we?
Well, that's right.
We do.
To Oz.
To Oz.
We want to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz. He is a wizard, a wizard, never a wizard there was.
Lions, tigers, and bears.
Lions?
And tigers?
And bears.
Oh, lions and tigers and bears? Oh my. Lions and tigers and bears? Oh my.
Lions and tigers and bears?
Oh my.
Lions and tigers and bears?
Oh my.
Lions and tigers and bears?
Oh my.
Lions and tigers and bears!
Padama! Padama! Which one of you fights? I'll fight you both together if you want. I'll fight you with one paw tied behind my back. I'll fight you standing on one foot. I'll fight you with my eyes closed. Oh, pulling an axe on me, eh? Sneaking up on me, eh? Why?
Go away and let us alone.
Oh, scared, huh? Afraid, huh? Must keep a new fresh in that can. Come on, get up and fight, you shivering junkyard. Put your hands up, you lopsided bag of hay.
Oh, that's getting personal, Lion.
Yes, why don't you get up and teach him a lesson?
Well, what's wrong with you teaching him?
Well, I hardly know.
Oh, I'll get you anyway, Pee-wee.
Oh, shame on you!
Oh, why did you go and do that for? I didn't fight him.
No, but you tried to. It's bad enough picking on a straw man, but when you go around picking on poor little dogs...
Oh, you didn't have to go and hit me, did you?
Is my nose bleeding?
Of course not.
Oh.
My goodness, what a fuss you're making. Naturally, when you go around picking on things weaker than you are, why, you're nothing but a great big coward.
Oh, you're right. I am a coward. I haven't got any courage at all. I even scare myself sometimes. Oh, look at the psychos under my eyes. I haven't slept in weeks.
Why don't you try counting sheep?
Oh, that doesn't do any good. I'm afraid of them.
Oh, that's too bad. Oh, why don't you come along with us? We're on our way to see the wizard now to get him a heart.
And him a brain.
Oh, I'm sure he could give you some courage.
No, but wouldn't you feel degraded to be caught in the company of a cowardly lion? I would.
No, of course not.
Oh, gee, that's awful nice of you. Why, my whole life's been simply unbearable. Even my family's disowned me. Why, when I was just a little cub, my father took me to the top of a high mountain, waved his paw around and said, "One day, son, this will all be yours." Oh, I was terrified.
Why's that?
I'm afraid of heights.
Well, it's all right. The wizard will fix everything.
Well, at least he'll be safe if I come with you.
How's that?
Oh, no self-respecting wild animal will come anywhere near me. Said a lion, a poor neurotic lion, to a miss who listened to him ring. Oh, the Lord made me a lion, but the Lord forgot to make me brave.
Then his tail began to curl and wave.
Life is sad, believe me, missy, when you're born to be a sissy without the feminine vibe. Oh, but I could change my habits, never more be scared of rabbits if I only had the nine. Ah! I'm afraid there's no denying, I'm just a dandelion, a fate I don't design. But it could show my prowess, be a lion, not a mouse, if I only had the nine.
A king down to the core.
You could roar the way you've never roared before.
And I'd rock and roar some more. I'd show the forest of us, king around the forest, a king named that aside. Who I with my regal visor, I could be another Caesar if I only had the nine. I'd be brave as a blizzard.
I'd be gentle as a lizard.
I'd be clever as a gizzard.
If the wizard is a wizard to discern,
then I'm sure to get a brain, a heart,
a home.
The knife.
We're hot to see the wizard.
Would you thief, we can take a shortcut.
The road curves around this poppy field. We can cut through and pick up on the other side.
Oh, let's go.
I've never seen such beautiful poppies.
I think poppies are my favorite flower.
You can't rest now. We've got to go on.
Come to think of it, 40 winks wouldn't be a bad idea.
Oh, don't you start too.
It's the poppies. Well, that's what's doing it.
Don't cry. You'll rust yourself again. Well, this is a spell. This is.
It's the Wicked Witch. Oh, what do we do? Help! Help!
It's no use screaming at a time like this. No one will hear you. Help! 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 Oh.
West, perhaps a little magic of my own will save the day.
help, Scarecrow. Let them know we're here.
Okay. Here goes. Who rang that bell?
Oh, don't do that.
We did.
Can't you read?
Read what?
The notice.
What notice?
Well, it's on the door. As plain as the nose on my face. It's rough. Just a minute.
Bell out of order. Please knock.
That's more like it. Now, take your business.
We want to see the wizard.
The wizard? Well, nobody can see the Great Oz. Nobody's ever seen the Great Oz. Even I've never seen him.
Well, then, how do you know there is one?
Well, because... Because... Well, if there wasn't a wizard, why would you be here?
Oh, please, please, sir. I've got to see the wizard. The good witch of the north sent me.
Prove it. She's wearing the ruby slippers she gave her. So she is. Well, bust my buttons. Why didn't you say that in the first place? That's a horse of a different color.
Who's she calling a horse? Why, if he wasn't on the other side of that door.
He's coming out.
Oh, he'd be on this side.
Welcome to the Emerald City.
Oh, thank you.
Have you come far?
Oh, just the longest of ways.
Oh, believe me, every step is worth it. Have you any idea just how wonderful a place this really is?
I've been trying to imagine it, but I haven't got a brain.
They said I'd fall in love with it if I had a heart.
It's the only place I don't need courage, because there's nothing there to scare me. Is there?
There's a garden spot, I'm told, where it's never too hot and it's never too cold.
Where you're never too young and we're never too old.
Where you're never too big or tall.
And you're never, never, never too anything at all.
Oh, we're not too mad and we're not too sane. And we don't compare and we don't complain. All we do is just sit tight, cause it's all so, so, so downright right. Ha, 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 ho, 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 and a couple of tra-la-las. That's how we laugh the day away, the merry old land of Oz. Buzz, 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 chirp, 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 and a couple of la-dee-das. That's how the crickets prick all day in the merry old land of Oz. Ha, ha, ha.
Take us to him?
Oh, is he scary?
The wizard? Oh, the wizard. Well, yes, of course, but let me take you to some place where you can tidy up with him first.
Oh, thank you. Oh, I'm so excited.
Oh, it's you.
Thank you.
Dorothy.
The wizard will explain it.
Here, everything is fine, The great and powerful Oz has got matters well in hand, I hope. And you can all go home now. Go home, everything is fine. Go. Can you not hear me? Go home, everything is fine. And hey, didn't you hear me? I said go home.
Oh, but that's what I'm trying to do, sir. That's why we've got to see the wizard right away, all four of us.
Orders are, nobody can see the great Oz. Not nobody, not no half.
Oh, but you said you'd take us to him.
And I got 5 minutes just for the occasion.
Not nobody, not no half.
Well, you just gotta make him see, Dorothy.
Dorothy? Did you say Dorothy? The witch's Dorothy?
In person.
Well, that makes a difference. Wait here, I'll announce you at once.
Did you hear that? He'll announce us at once. I've as good as got my brain.
I can fairly hear my heart beating.
I'll be home in time for supper.
In another hour, I'll be king of the forest. Long live the king! If I were king of the forest, not queen, not duke, not prince, my regal robes of the forest would be satin, not cotton, oh, not chintz. I'd command each thing, be it fish or fowl, with a woof and a woof and a rival growl. Meow! As I click my heel, how the trees would kneel, and the mountains bow, and the bulls kowtow, and the sparrows would take a wing. If I were a king, to me, that chipmunk's genuflect, to me, though my tail would lash, I'd show compassion for every underling. If I were a king, just king. Preposterous!
Well, to help out a hippopotamus!
I'd thrash him from top to bottomus!
Supposing
you had an elephant?
I'd wrap him up in cellophant!
Well, but what if it were a brontosaurus?
I'd show him who was king of the forest!
To help!
How?
Courage! What makes a king out of a slave? Courage! What makes the flag on the mast wave? Courage! What makes the elephant charge its tusk in the misty mist of the dusky dusk? What makes the muskrat guard his musk? Courage! What makes the sphinx the seventh wonder? Courage! What makes the dawn come up like thunder? Courage! What makes the hottentot so hot? What puts the ape an apricot? What have they got that I ain't got?
Courage!
You can say that again.
Held and crowned by every hundred
king. If I were king.
go away!
Oh, but surely...
He is deaf to all appeals. The wizard has spoken.
Oh, looks like we came a long way for nothing.
Oh, and I was so happy. I thought I was on my way home.
Oh, don't cry, Dorothy. We'll get you to see the wizard somehow.
We certainly will.
And DM was so good to me, and I never appreciated it. Running away and hurting her feelings. Professor Marble said she was sick. She may even be dying, and it's all my fault. Oh, I'll never forgive myself. Never, never, never.
Please don't cry anymore. I'll get you to the wizard somehow.
Oh, thank you.
That's all right. I knew not him myself once. Wait here, I'll see if I can change his mind.
Oh, wait a minute, fellas. I was just thinking. I really don't want to see the wizard as much. I better wait for you outside.
What's the matter? The wizard's going to give you some courage.
Oh, I'd be too afraid to ask him for it.
It's okay, Lion. We'll be scared together.
No!
What happened?
Somebody pulled my tail.
You did it yourself.
Oh, I'm such a butt of paws.
The great Oz awaits you.
Tell me when it's over. Oh, look at that. Oh, look at that. Oh, I want to go home.
I am Oz, the great and powerful. Who are you? Who are you?
If you please, sir, I am Dorothy, the small and meek. Oh, well, we've come to ask you for...
Crickets! The great and powerful Oz knows why you have come. Step forward, Tin Man. You dare come to me for a heart. Do you? You clicky, collection of Caligonus junk!
Yes, sir. Yes, Your Honor. You see, a while back, we were walking down the yellow brick road, and we came across a field of poppies, and you see...
Quiet! And you, Scarecrow, have the effrontery to ask for a brain? You villain, bovine butter!
Yes, Your Honor. Your Excellency.
Enough! And you, Lion.
Oh, you ought to be ashamed of yourself, frightening him like that when he came to you for help.
Silence, Whippersnapper! The great and beneficent Oz has every intention of granting your request.
What did he say?
Oh, are you all right?
Oh, yeah, just a little deaf. What did he say?
He's coming to help us after all.
Oh, he is?
But first, you must prove yourselves worthy by performing a very small task.
A small task? Is that all?
You name it, and it's half done.
Bring me the broomstick of the Witch of the West.
But in order to do that, we have to kill her first.
Bring me her broomstick, and I'll grant your request. Now go!
Oh, wait, but what if she kills us first?
I said go!
I wish you'd given up this crazy scheme. I never should have let you see the wizard.
Oh, but I'm glad you did. How else would I get back to Kansas?
Well, you don't have to worry about us.
We're not going up to the witch empty-handed.
You can say that again.
Which way to her castle?
Well, no one knows for sure. Oh,
you mean no one's ever gone there?
Oh, sure, plenty folk have gone there, but No one's ever come back.
Oh, boy.
Oh, there's no yellow brick road to follow now.
No, there's no road at all to the land of the Winkies.
Winkies? Oh, what's Winkies?
Oh, well, once they were people very like us. The Wicked Witch made them her slaves.
Oh.
I hope the same thing doesn't happen to you.
Oh, so do I.
Keep going to the west where the sun sets.
Oh, is that the best way to find the Wicked Witch?
Oh, you won't have to find her, Dorothy. When she knows you're in the land of the Winkies, she'll find you. Good luck.
Sometimes it's a good thing not to have a brain. I haven't the wit to be scared.
And I haven't the heart to fail.
And I haven't said goodbye to the wizard just yet. Oh, no!
How can you desert Dorothy now?
Well, I could stay here. That's one way of doing it.
Shame on you. You're even more of a coward than I thought.
Well, that's easy for you to say. You're made of straw and you're made of tin. But I am only weak flesh.
Very weak, verging on flabby.
Oh, it's all right, Lion. You can stay here if you'd like.
I'd like. Oh, how I'd like. But if you really need me, I'll tag along, I guess.
That's more like it.
Oh.
You're a stout fellow.
Oh.
Ready to go, Dorothy?
Best foot forward.
Decisions. Decisions.
Come on, Lion.
Oh, I'm coming. I'm coming. Scarecrow's not the only one who needs a new brain.
Keep in step.
What does it mean, anyway?
It's an old Winky marching song, meaning roughly, yo, wee, yo, yo.
Once bitten, they can never stop dancing. drop. And when they do, you will be there to scoop up the little brat and the little brute and bring them both here to me. Now go do my bidding. Fly, fly, fly.
A while back.
You mean the one that said, welcome to the haunted forest?
No, the one that said, if you've got this far, you're lost.
Oh, here's another notice.
Oh, I hope it's something a little more reassuring.
I'd turn back if I were you.
Fine.
No.
I believe there are spooks around here.
That's ridiculous. Spooks? That's silly.
Oh, but you don't believe in spooks?
No, only fools would believe.
Oh, help!
I do believe in spooks. 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 I do.
Oh! So do I! Did you just hear what I just heard?
That noise don't come from an ordinary bird.
It may be just a cricket or a critter in a tree.
It's giving me the jitters and the joints around the knees.
I think I see a shadow and it's fuzzy and it's furry.
I haven't got a brain, but I think I ought to worry.
I haven't got a heart, but I feel a palpitation.
That's Monica, the funnest animal like this situation.
Are you gonna send a rat that him fill us full of horror?
Well, I'd like to roar him down. But I think I lost my roarer.
Oh!
Oh!
Oh! Oh!
It's a who's-is.
It's a who's-is.
It's a what's-is.
It's a what's-is.
Who's that?
Who's there?
Who's where?
Beware! That hiding the tree tops that let go. The jitterbug. You catch him.
Bats in the trees couldn't do what the jitterbug does, so just be careful about rascal. Keep away from the jitterbug. The jitterbug.
The jitterbug. Oh, no.
Whoa!
Where even are we?
Pot off me, you dirty apes.
Oh, fine job we did of protecting Dorothy.
Well, help, help.
Well, what happened to you?
Well, they tore my leg off and they threw it over there. And then they tore my arm off and they threw it over there.
Scarecrow, that's you all over.
Sam, you pulled yourself together.
I would, but I can't reach my leg.
Here, I'll get it.
And then we'll go find Dorothy.
That's right. Oh, and the lion will lead us.
Yeah! I will?
Yes, you.
I am gonna lead us against the forces of evil?
That's right.
All right. I'll do it. I'll do it for Dorothy. Wicked witch or no wicked witch. Gods or no gods, I'll tear them apart. I may not come out alive, but I'll go down fighting. There's only one thing I want you fellas to do.
What's that?
Duck me out of it.
Somehow.
Don't cry. cry. We haven't got the oil can with us, and you've been squeaking enough as it is.
Well, they say it's got 1,000 rooms. How are we going to find which one Dorothy's in?
Oh, it's Toto!
Why, Dorothy?
Well, we still have to get in there somehow.
Do you think it'll be polite? Just dropping in like this?
Oh, look out!
Oh, who's that? Who's that?
I've got a plan how to get in there.
Fine. He's got a plan.
Oh, it might not work.
Oh, it might not work.
But it's got a chance.
Oh, but it's got a chance.
Only thing is, it's very, very dangerous. What do you say?
I say. Anyone else got a plan?
Let's hear the scarecrows.
First thing is, we need to get a hold of 3 Winky Uniforms.
Where are we going to find 3 Winky Uniforms?
Fellas?
I don't know, but the whole plan depends on it.
All 3 Winky Uniforms.
Fellas? I don't think we're going to have to look all that far.
Why's that?
Because they're coming up right behind us.
Take her back the way we came.
What about the window?
The cliff is sheer.
Oh. Why don't I hang on with my claws and you all hang on to my tail?
Oh, you're wonderful, all of you.
I just hope my courage holds out.
We hope your tail holds out.
To the window.
Oh, so. We won't care of it, will we, Winky?
Oh, fellas, I think we got to stand our welcome.
Ring around the rosy, a pocket full of spears. The sands of time have run out for all of you. The last to go will see the first 3 before her, and your mangy little mutt, too. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo, who shall be the first to go? Lion, girl, tin man, no, my broom has chosen.
No, help!
What's the matter, Scarecrow? Don't you want to be my old flame?
Oh, leave him alone. Can't you see he's terrified?
I'll get around to you eventually, Miss Mouth.
She's dead. You killed her.
Oh, I didn't mean to kill her. Really, I didn't. It's just that she was going to set him on fire.
Hail! Hail to Dorothy! The wicked witch is dead.
Hail! Hail to Dorothy! The wicked witch is dead!
You are now our queen.
Oh, that's very kind of you, but I've got to get back to Kansas. The witch's broomstick. Oh, may we have it?
Please, take it.
Oh, thank you very much. Now we can go to the wizard and tell him the wicked witch is dead.
The wicked witch is dead.
As for you, my fine friend,
You are under the unfortunate delusion that simply because you run away from danger, you have no courage. You're confusing courage with wisdom. Back where I come from, we have men who are called heroes. Once a year, they take their fortitude out of the mothballs and parade it down the main streets of the city with no more courage than you have. But they have one thing you haven't got, a medal. Therefore, for meritorious conduct, extraordinary valor, and conspicuous bravery against wicked witches, I hereby award you the Triple Cross. You are now a member of the Legion of Courage.
Shucks, folks, I'm speechless.
And as for you, my galvanized friend, you want a heart. You don't know how lucky you are not to have one. Hearts will never be made practical until they can be made unbreakable.
But I still want one.
Back where I come from, we have men that do nothing all day but good deeds. They're called philanthropy. Good deed doers. And they've got no more of a heart than you. But they have one thing you haven't got, a testimonial. Therefore, in consideration of your kindness, I'd like to present you with a small token of our esteem and affection. And remember, my sentimental friend, a heart is not judged by how much you love, but by how much you are loved by others.
Oh, it ticks. Oh, my God, I've got a heart and it ticks.
Oh, read what my medal says.
Awarded for courage.
Oh, ain't it the truth? Ain't it the truth?
Oh, they're all so wonderful.
Oh, hey, what about Dorothy?
Oh, yes, what about Dorothy?
Yeah, Dorothy next.
Oh, yes, Dorothy.
Oh, I don't think there's anything in there for me.
Well, my child, you forced me into a cataclysmic decision. The only way to get Dorothy back to Kansas is for me to take her there myself.
Oh, will you? Could you? But are you a clever enough wizard to manage it?
My child, you cut me to the quick. I'm an old Kansas man myself. Premier balloonist par excellence to the Miracle Wonderland Carnival Company. When one day, while performing a feat of stratospheric skill, the balloon failed to return to the fair.
It did?
Frightened, were you?
Frightened? You're talking to a man who has laughed in the face of death, sneered at danger, and chuckled at catastrophe. I was petrified. But then, suddenly, the wind changed. And the balloon landed in the noble heart of this city, where I was instantly acclaimed Oz, first wizard deluxe.
Oh, deluxe, from the French, pertaining to luxury.
Yes, well, there were a few luxuries that came with the job, but I took it anyway, keeping the balloon for the advent of a quick getaway. And the balloon is ready for the flight. And in that conveyance, my dear Dorothy, you and I shall return to the land of E Pluribus Unum. Step this way. Citizens of Oz, I, your wizard, per ardua et alta, am about to embark upon a hazardous and technically unexplainable journey into the outer stratosphere. To confer, converse, and otherwise hobnob with my brother wizards. And until such a time, if any, that I return, the Scarecrow, by virtue of his highly superior brains, shall rule in my stead, assisted by the Tin Man, by virtue of his magnificent heart, and the Lion, by virtue of his courage. Obey them as you would me. Thank you, my friends. Thank you. And now, I think it's time to cast off. Climb aboard, Dorothy. Climb aboard.
Climb aboard, Missy, while the wind's still in your favor.
Oh, where's Toto? Oh, I can't go without him. Toto?
Well, I'll get your dog for you.
Oh, don't let go! The rope!
What?
This is highly irregular procedure.
Oh, the balloon's going up.
Oh, help! Help!
Oh, don't go, Professor!
Dear dog.
This is absolutely unprecedented!
Oh, you can't leave without me!
Too late, my dear.
Oh, you have to come back!
I can't come back. I don't know how it works. Goodbye, folks! Goodbye!
Bye.
Goodbye!
That idiot guard ruined my exit.
I'll never get home.
Stay with us, Dorothy. We don't want you to go.
But I have to get back to Kansas.
Don't you love us, Dorothy?
You know I do. But there's a place and people that I love more. And now it's further away in the furthest dream. Oh, Scarecrow, I'll never see Kansas again for as long as I live. Never, never, never. Never is a very, very long time, Dorothy. Oh, will you help me? Can you help me?
When all the world's in a hopeless jumble and the raindrops tumble all around, heaven opens a magic lane.
When all the clouds darken up the skyway, there's a rainbow highway to be found.
Why didn't you tell her sooner?
Because she had to learn it for herself. She wouldn't have believed me otherwise.
Well, what have you learned, Dorothy?
Well, I think that it isn't enough just to want to see Uncle Henry and Auntie Em. And that if I ever go looking for my heart's desire again, I won't look further than my own backyard. Because if it isn't there, then I never really lost anything to begin with. Is that right?
That's all it is.
But that's so easy. I should have thought of it for you.
I should have felt it in my heart.
Me too, if I have the courage of my convictions.
No. She had to learn it for herself. Now those ruby slippers will take you home in 2 seconds.
Oh, Toto 2?
Toto 2. Oh, it's going to be so hard to say goodbye. I love you all so much. Oh, goodbye, Tin Man. Oh, don't cry. Oh, you rust so dreadfully. Oh, here. Here's your oil can. Goodbye.
Oh, it both got hard. Because it's breaking.
Oh, goodbye, Lion. I know it isn't right, but I'm gonna miss the way you used to holler for help before you found your courage.
Well, after you're gone, I think I'll do a little more hollering. No, don't go!
Oh, dear Scarecrow, you were my first friend here. I think maybe I'll miss you most of all.
Having a brain don't make parting any easier. Goodbye, Dorothy. Well, I'll think of you always.
Are you ready to go now?
Yes, yes, please. Before I change my mind and stay forever.
Then close your eyes and tap your heels together 3 times and think to yourself, there's no place like home. There's no place like home. There's no place like home. 1, there's no place like home. 2, there's no place like home. 3, goodbye, Dorothy.
Stop imagining things.
Let me have her, Dorothy. I'm a Kansas man myself. She's dead. You killed her.
The Great Oz has spoken.
Is my nose bleeding?
The tinsmith forgot to give me a heart.
Those without brains do an awful lot of talking.
All you do is follow the yellow brick road.
I'll get you, my pretty, and your little dog, too.
Toto, I have a feeling we're not in Kansas anymore. There's no place like home. There's no place like home. There's no place like home.
Dorothy! Oh, little girl? Oh, little girl! Oh, I'd hate to think of the kid out all night in the storm. We best get into town and notify the sheriff. Wait, Toto? There she is! Dorothy? Oh, Dorothy?
There's no place like home. There's no place.
Zeke! Hunk! Hickory! She's over here! Tell Emmy and better bring a blanket!
Oh, there's a lump on her head like an ostrich egg. But the skin ain't broken.
Hello, Oz.
Oz? My first name is Chester, but you can call me whatever you'd like.
Uncle Henry, you were a winky.
I'm watching over you now, honey. I'll see you come to no more harm.
Is she all right?
There was a minute there where I thought she left us.
Oh, but Uncle Henry, that's just the trouble. I did leave you. And I tried to get back for days and days.
Sounds like a bad dream.
Oh, but it wasn't a dream.
Sure it wasn't. Remember me, your old pal Zeke?
Lion.
No, it ain't. And this here's Hickory.
You couldn't forget my face, could you?
Oh, no, of course not. But, oh, where's Scarecrow?
Scarecrow?
Who the heck's Scarecrow?
Oh, here's the blanket you called for. How is she?
She'll be fine.
You've lost all your stuffing.
Stuffing?
What'll happen to the field mouse in your stomach?
I had more than a field mouse. He gave me a whole sack of kittens in there.
Oh, Dorothy! Auntie Em! Oh, Dorothy, you're safe and well. Auntie Em, I saw you in the witch's crystal ball.
Dorothy?
Oh, no, no, you don't understand. This was a truly live place. And I remember that some of it wasn't very nice. Oh, but most of it was beautiful. And you were all there. You kept rusting up, and you kept pulling your own tail, and you were a humbug.
Well now, let's not get personal.
Doesn't anybody believe me? Of course we believe you, Dorothy, but now we've got to get you to bed. Oh, has the house come back yet? It fell on the witch, you know.
The storm passed right by it,
and it wasn't a house that fell on the skull.
Yeah, it was a telegraph pole. We won't be hearing from that old biddy till her leg gets out of plaster.
Then Toto is safe. Oh, you hear that, Toto? We're both safe, and we're going home. Home. And you're all here, and I love you all. And oh, Auntie Em, there really is no place like home.